Good morning, everybody. My name's Alex Louise. I'm a money success coach. And you may say, well, why are you here talking about property? If you don't sort your money out first, your property deals are going to go south. It's a fact. You've just heard it from some of the guys here saying, do your preparation, do your due diligence. So who I am for you guys is the possibility of financial freedom. I coach groups and I put people together who alone really struggle to do property. But when I specialize in putting people together and managing a group and facilitating a group to get financially free together. So the reason that I'm passionate about that is I left school at 15. I worked as a pot washer in a kitchen and then had a career as a chef for 17 years. And alongside doing that, I bought properties. And I did it in Wales, which if any of you have seen the properties in Wales, they're a lot cheaper than here. So the figures work, they stack. There are areas in Wales not to buy. But generally, the figures work. It's a very nice place to live as well. So who I am for you is building good relationships and actually the possibility of happiness, which sounds a bit weird, right? We've come here to look at properties and talk about money, but if you don't do both, you end up rich and miserable. Has anyone ever met a rich and miserable person? It's like the worst kind of person, right? Because it's like they've got everything, still not happy. So my invitation to all of you on your journey, especially there's quite a lot of you starting out by the sounds of it here today, not here to buy, is to really look at what it is you want from your life and consider that property is the access to that. And that will give you the access to what you want. But if you don't create what you want when you become financially free, you'll do what I did, which was at 32, left my last chef's job, funnily enough, in London, went back to Wales to do just property and didn't have a clue who I was. Literally didn't have a clue, because my whole goal since the age of 15 was get financially free by 30. Got to 32, left my job, didn't have the identity as a chef anymore, and literally didn't know what to do. So spent some time doing more talks on cooking. I used to teach people to cook as well. And people started asking me, how did I do the property stuff? How did I do the journey? Could we meet for a coffee? And everything just kind of naturally progressed. So I don't have business cards. I've been asked for it a few times this morning. I'm sorry about that. All my work comes from referrals and recommendations from existing clients. You can find me on social media. My email is alexlouise7@gmail.com. Please get in touch if you're interested in building a joint venture team that works. And I really invite you to consider that if your relationships don't work, your property journey actually won't work. If you can't build relationships with people and you can't work with people and understand when there's a breakdown happening, how to navigate through that, that's why joint ventures don't work. So they are the most incredible, powerful thing that you can do in property and in money and in business generally. But the biggest way that people fall down is that they don't understand how to deal with breakdowns and how to communicate when people are being different in their personalities. Who here has someone in their life that is not quite working right? Whether it's family, business, whatever it is. Maybe it's a profession that's annoyed you because they're a different personality demographic to you. You have to deal with that if you want to be successful in property. So my invitation to you is really look at the wider picture. The property journey is great. The strategies are amazing. There are people in this room who can help you with everything. But really get that it's not just the property strategy alone. You have to understand your why and what drives you. And you have to have the people around you to help facilitate the breakdowns, because they will come. We will have tax changes like we've just had. We will have removal of sections that make it harder for us to run our businesses. We will have additional stamp duty, and there'll be more. We will have another recession. It's not about whether it happens or not, it's when it happens, and are you in the right place to deal with it when it does happen? So I really, those of you who haven't bought a property yet, it's a flipping exciting journey. Really, really just go for it and get people around you to help you do it so that you do it successfully. Have a great day and speak to you all later. Thank you. So my question to you is, why do you want to do them first? So I have a group that does rent-to-rents backed with a lease option to complete on the purchase using the profit made as the deposit. They're doing that because at the moment they're capital short, so it's a way that they can raise money and keep doing deals in the time while they're also raising other finance. You need to be really good at managing people, and you need to really understand what the potential is for failure and the potential for doom. And I don't say that lightly. I really strongly believe that options attract irresponsible actions. And if you haven't got the money to back up things going wrong, it can sound like a really sweet deal to get into an option with no money, no mortgage, no responsibility. But if you don't have the money and the backing and the experience behind you to deal with it going wrong, it's really going to hurt. And it doesn't just hurt you, it hurts your tenants, it hurts the property owner, and it hurts everyone involved. So you need to be really good at managing people, and you also need to be really good at negotiating, and you need to have the option written in a way that deals with the market going up, but also the market going down. And I believe that if you don't set an option up as a win-win for everybody involved in every eventuality, you will come unstuck. And the potential is you'll end up with a vendor who's really angry at what you've done to them, because you might get them out of a sticky spot now, but if the market rises, they may feel ripped off and you'll have to deal with that. So, sure, so you can still do it, but what I'm saying is don't go into it thinking it's the easy way. It gets touted as a kind of easy way to get into property, and actually it's not. You have to deal with all of the same issues in property, and you don't have control of the property. So actually, I would say it's more risky. And this is just my personal opinion. There are people who do it and it works and it's great. But what I'm saying is don't go into it lightly thinking it's an easy route, because you don't control the property. So find people who do it and do it well, and do one at a time. The other thing with options is people kind of go, oh my God, this is so easy, I just need a couple of thousand in, and you try and do several deals. Do one and see if it works. Do one and see if you like it, and if you can actually manage it. And really, I can't stress enough, you've got to make sure that you've got the resources behind you to deal with things if they go wrong. If you go into it with a zero bank balance and no availability of any cash behind you, if it goes wrong, it's really going to hurt.